In this video, I will share with you 7 expensive habits that will keep you poor forever. In this video, I will share with you 11 millionaire habits you should be doing right now. Habit number 1, budgeting. Just about every millionaire leverages a benefit of budgeting, but how they formulate their budgets can vary. Most millionaires set annual budgets for their spending, which are often broken down into monthly budgets. It's not uncommon for these rich individuals to even operate using a weekly budget, allowing them to analyze their spending and saving on a more granular basis. Unfortunately, the majority of people see budgeting as a dirty term, and the act of budgeting as a chore more than a life-changing tool. But if you want to increase your wealth and become a millionaire, then budgeting is something that you're just going to have to turn into a habit. I personally started tracking my expenses about 2 years ago, and have found that I am much more aware of how much I am earning, but more importantly, how much I am spending. This not only allows me to see how much I am spending, but where, which allows me to pinpoint areas to cut back on, ultimately saving me more money. And quite honestly, the act of budgeting and tracking wasn't that hard. I start every month with my expected income and my savings target, and allocate the difference between my expenses, tracking each expenditure in the notes on my smartphone. Habit number 2, being proactive. There are 2 types of people in this world. The ones who react and the ones who take charge. And as you can probably guess, millionaires do the latter. The term proactive is defined as creating or controlling a situation by causing something to happen, rather than responding to it after it has happened. And millionaires understand achieving financial success is totally dependent on their own actions and not on the actions of others. Poor people, on the other hand, are quick to blame everyone but themselves when they run into financial struggles. They say that the government is taxing them too much, that their boss isn't promoting them, or that the economy is holding them back. In essence, they are reacting to the world around them instead of taking charge. For myself, instead of waiting for a good paying job to come my way, I took it upon myself to get multiple degrees and designations in order to make my financial success a certainty. Habit number 3, reading. Millionaires are living examples of the phrase, "the more you learn, the more you earn," which is why they are constantly increasing their knowledge through reading. For instance, every year Bill Gates takes reading vacations just to catch up on the books he wants to finish. And when Warren Buffett first started his investing career, he read between 600 and 1,000 pages a day. After studying numerous high-wealth individuals, the act of reading was pervasive amongst all of them. You see, reading allows you to learn new ideas, concepts, and open your mind to new possibilities. These findings are often used to start new businesses, which help generate profits and ultimately make the millionaire even richer than they already are. But what types of books do they read, you may be asking? Nonfiction books on social skills, business development, economics, and other self-development related areas are great places to start. Even staying current on world news can help you make more informed decisions in your day-to-day life. This is why I can't stress enough just how important reading is to your financial success. For myself, I have begun reading a book a week, and I'm on pace to hit my target of reading 52 books in 2019. And if you want to become rich, you should do the same. Habit number 4, being curious. Funny enough, this habit ties into habit number 3, because if you're reading something that you're not curious about, it's not going to be enjoyable. Think back to high school when your teacher would assign you mandatory readings. You struggled to get through the readings as you saw the activity as a chore and not a pleasure. But if you think back to a time where you were reading a book you found immensely interesting, you probably found yourself barely able to put the book down. What millionaires understand is that being curious goes hand in hand with learning. And as I just mentioned, lifelong learning is key to financial success. I think Steve Jobs captured this idea perfectly when he said, "Much of what I stumbled upon by following my curiosity and intuition turned out to be priceless later on." Who knows, maybe we wouldn't have the smartphones we carry around every single day if he hadn't let his curiosity guide him. Habit number 5, valuing mentorship. It is said that having a mentor is like reading 1,000 books, and millionaires know just how impactful a good mentor can be. But if millionaires are already rich, why would they need a mentor? Mentorship is valuable at all levels of wealth, which is why wealthy individuals appear to place even more value on mentorship as their wealth grows. Take Mark Zuckerberg as an example. After already having created Facebook and having billions of dollars to his name, Zuckerberg still sought out advice from those around him. One mentor in particular was none other than Steve Jobs, who taught Mark how to build teams that were just as passionate about high-quality products and services as he was. Unfortunately, poor people avoid mentorship for 2 reasons. First, they think that learning everything on their own is the best way to become wealthy, rather than leveraging the knowledge that has helped other people achieve their own financial goals. Second, they don't put in the time to build the social relationships that will allow them to pursue mentorship opportunities, which significantly decreases their chances of ever becoming a millionaire. So if you want to learn faster and get rich quicker, mentorship is the way to go. Habit number 6, setting goals. Goals are extremely important in any aspect of life, and your finances are no different. Goals are beneficial for multiple reasons. First, having goals allows you to set out a detailed path to your success, which reduces the time wasted trying to maneuver your way towards financial achievement. Second, they act as motivation, especially when reviewed daily. But what separates the use of goals by millionaires and the average person is that millionaires know the secrets that can exponentially increase the achievement of their goals. First, millionaires set goals using the SMART goal framework. This method requires that your goal be specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and timely. For instance, using the SMART goal framework, your financial goal could be increase my income by $30,000 in 12 months by completing 10 extra freelance projects. Having a robust goal that satisfies all the elements of the SMART goal framework will make you significantly more likely to reach these goals, especially when you compound this technique with the other millionaire goal setting secret. What most millionaires will tell you about goals is that they must be written down. A Harvard Business study found that the 3% of graduates from their MBA who had their goals written down ended up earning 10 times as much as the other 97% put together, just 10 years after graduation. But once you have your goals written down, you must also review them. It's stated that people who very vividly describe or picture their goals are anywhere from 1.2 to 1.4 times more likely to successfully accomplish their goals than people who don't. Therefore, it's not enough to just set SMART goals, but reviewing them daily will further reinforce their importance, allowing you to achieve them much quicker. Habit number 7, keep a to-do list. Millionaires know that achieving financial success takes constant action, which is why they pride themselves on getting things done. However, how do you know what needs to get done without a plan? Most millionaires will create to-do lists of the things they must accomplish every day, which as you guessed is linked directly to their detailed goals. Keeping a to-do list not only allows them to stay organized and map their actions to their goals, but allows them to maintain their motivation as they cross off item after item from their list. Moreover, it allows them to focus their daily actions to only pertain to these key activities, which allows them to avoid time-wasting activities. So if you want to get more done and increase your chances of becoming rich, then you need to keep a to-do list of your most important activities. Habit number 8, maintaining multiple sources of income. The average millionaire has 7 sources of income, and if you want to be rich, then you must begin to expand how you make money. For the average person, their sole way of earning income is through their job. But as of 2018, more than 3 million people lost jobs that they had held for the prior 3 years, meaning that having your job as the only way you earn income is risky. Moreover, having a job as your sole source of income means that you can only make money when you're working. As Warren Buffett says, if you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. Which is why millionaires leverage income sources that can make them money around the clock. This can include dividend investing, real estate, royalties, and interest income. In short, millionaires know that income sources come and go, which is why having multiple streams supporting you will ensure you continue to progress towards your financial goals. Habit number 9, not diversifying. You've probably heard the advice, diversify your portfolio and you'll become rich. Well, if you study most millionaires, you will soon learn that this isn't how most people become rich. Millionaires become wealthy by putting all their eggs in one basket and then watching that basket to make sure none of the eggs break. Unfortunately, most broke people go from one idea to the next, never putting all their energy into one endeavor, which causes their progress to be stunted and them to ultimately quit. To become a millionaire, you need to focus on only one thing. Put all of your energy and focus on one project and don't diversify. If you look at Mark Cuban, he started one company and nurtured it until it became a success. Then moved on to the second and third business, but only once the preceding one was already doing well. So if you want to see quick progress in your financial endeavors, then you must have laser focus in everything you do. Habit number 10, avoiding wasted time. We live in a world full of distractions, and what really separates the rich from the poor is their ability to block out these distractions and keep their wasted time to a minimum. You see, millionaires see their time in terms of dollars, and while browsing Facebook for an hour may seem harmless to you, for them, they equate this squandered time to the loss of hundreds or even thousands of dollars. If you know that you are often guilty of wasting time, then you need to start valuing your time more. Turn that hour of scrolling through Instagram into an hour of reading, networking, or creating. And if you think you can only see noticeable progress by eliminating large chunks of wasted time, think again. If you spend 30 minutes writing a book for a year, you could have like 2 or 3 books written, and I can almost guarantee that. Habit number 11, focus on high value activities. Let's face it, not all activities in life have the same level of importance, and when it comes to your financial goals, this is certainly true. Unfortunately, in life, we have a finite amount of time every day, which means that we need to prioritize the activities that will allow us to progress towards goals and minimize any tasks that don't. For instance, if you have the goal of making $100,000 this year, then which activity would be more helpful in the pursuit of this target? Spending an hour going grocery shopping or spending that same hour closing a sales deal with a client? After studying numerous millionaires, I've noticed that a lot of them focus their attention on their highest earning activities. This could mean prioritizing a meeting for a $10 million contract over an internal staff meeting with your team or processing client invoices. Sadly, broke people have no method of prioritizing their activities, which leads them to spending endless hours on tasks that will not get them any closer to their financial goals. For example, they may spend 2 hours trying to find coupons to save $20 on groceries, when instead they could be putting in 2 hours on a freelance project that would earn them 5 times that amount. In short, if you want to become a millionaire, then you must use the finite time you have to make progress on your highest value activities. Habit number 1, spending more than you make. Let's face it, spending money is fun. In fact, there is scientific evidence to support this phenomenon. When you're considering buying something, your brain releases dopamine. Dopamine is a chemical produced by our brains that plays a starring role in motivating behavior. It gets released when we take a bite of food, when we have sex, after we exercise, and when we spend money. In an evolutionary context, it rewards us for beneficial behaviors and motivates us to repeat them. This is why humans have such a hard time resisting spending, and often this spending is only curbed when all funds have been depleted and credit cards have been maxed out. However, when people come into money, this problem perpetuates. Maybe you got a bonus at work, or maybe you got a promotion. These increases in income trigger our inclination to spend as we continue to chase that dopamine high. But it's not just the dopamine high that makes us open our wallets and spend. We also feel an intense need to fit in with our peers, and one way we can maintain our social status in society is by having the nicest clothes or the newest car. Unfortunately, this incessant spending is keeping you broke. You see, if you spend every dollar you make, you will never be able to save money, invest, or retire. What separates the rich from the poor is the management of their money. Whereas the majority of people spend every new dollar they earn, the rich maintain their modest lifestyles as their incomes rise. This allows them to begin saving more and more money as their cash flow increases. But the rich don't just hoard this money. They then deploy this money into investments like Roth IRAs, mutual funds, investment properties, or their own business to allow this cash to grow further. Therefore, if you want to become wealthy, then you must avoid spending more as your income rises. Habit number 2, sacrificing future happiness for present pleasure. There are two types of people in this world, those who live for today and those who build for tomorrow. And unfortunately, the majority of people fall into the first category. Now, don't get me wrong, enjoying the present is very important because no one knows how long each of us have to live. But more likely than not, you will make it to tomorrow, and if you are always trading future rewards for present pleasure, then you will never be rich. This trade-off is actually one of the big differentiators between the rich and the poor. When the rich make more money, they forego the desire to spend the money today, and instead sock it away into savings and investments that grow in value and provide financial resources that can be used in the future to maintain their current standard of living. In financial terms, delaying gratification is known as delay discounting, and it takes place when someone decides to discount the value of future rewards to immediately gratify themselves, even though accepting a lesser reward isn't exactly rational. The rich know that future payoffs will be greater than present rewards, and studies strongly support how this restraint from present gratification can lead to larger income realizations in the future. In a study of over 2,500 people, participants were asked whether they would hypothetically accept a smaller sum of money, $500 USD, or a larger sum, $1,000 USD, after a delay, which could be 1 day, 1 week, 1 month, 6 months, or a year. When the researchers used machine learning algorithms to model the relationship between individuals' tendency for delay discounting and the other self-reported variables, they found that delay discounting was more predictive of income than age, ethnicity, race, and height. Therefore, if you truly want to become rich, then you must take the future into perspective whenever you're making financial decisions. Although it is good to take care of everything in the present, do your best to save for your future. Habit number 3. You think you're too young to worry about saving. Let's be real, when we're young, our primary focus is to look cool and fit in with those around us. To do this, we buy the newest clothes and the latest gadgets to feel like we are part of the in crowd. We are much more worried about our social status than saving for a house or for our retirement. This carefree attitude leads us to spending every penny we earn, leaving little to support us down the road. In reality, you are never too young to start saving and just as importantly, investing. Take Warren Buffett for example. He bought his first stock at age 11 and over the course of numerous decades has leveraged his mastery in investing to become one of the richest men in the world. Let's use an example to illustrate just how important it is to get serious about your finances from an early age. Say we have two people, Mike and Steve. Mike begins investing at age 19, investing $2,000 a year at 12% for just 8 years, meaning that his last investment is at age 26. Steve, on the other hand, waits until he's 27 to start investing and invests $2,000 a year at 12% until age 65. Who do you think will end up with more money at age 65? Well, Steve seems like the logical choice because he invested for 39 years compared to Mike's 8 years. Mike actually ends up with an extra $700,000 over Steve because of when he started investing. So as this example proves, it is never too early to start saving and more importantly, investing your money. Habit number 4, not tracking your spending. We all think we know where our money comes from and where it ends up. Sadly, that's not true for most of us. We might be aware of our major expenditures like buying a car or getting a new phone, but the small things usually eat up our finances more than the big ones. For instance, when I used to not track my expenses, more often than not I would open up my credit card statement at month's end and be completely shocked by how much bigger my bill was than I anticipated. The truth is that all the nights out, coffees, and clothes I was buying was adding up to much more than a large expenditure would every month, which squandered any chance I had at saving money. It was only once I came across a quote by Peter Drucker, "What isn't measured isn't managed," that I knew that I had to change my ways and started tracking my expenses. Being the lazy person that I am, I avoided setting up complicated apps or programs and simply began writing down all my purchases in my iPhone notes. This simple yet effective strategy allowed me to see exactly where my money was going, and I still use this technique to this day. However, the strategy didn't solve all my money issues, because while I was tracking my expenditures, I still found myself overspending, which leads us to habit number 5. Habit number 5, lack of budgeting. Now, maybe you are already tracking your spending. If so, great. But if you don't spend according to a plan, then you may still find yourself in financial trouble. You see, you could be tracking the fact that you are spending hundreds of dollars on drinks and clothes every month, causing you to rack up a significant amount of credit card debt, which will leave you in as much trouble as if you weren't tracking at all. This is where a budget comes in, and one of the best ways to budget is by using the 20-30-50 method. This budgeting technique works by dividing your income in the following three ways. 50% is designated to living expenses like rent, utilities, and groceries. The next 30% goes towards entertainment costs like going out to eat or seeing a movie. The final 20% is meant to go right into your savings account. This means that you can now track your expenses according to the amounts you've designated at the start of each month, ensuring that your money goals are achieved. Habit number 6, ignoring your debt. As of June 2019, Americans are in more than $500 billion worth of credit card debt, with the average household having a balance of almost $7,000 on their cards. This insane amount of debt doesn't even factor in auto loans, student debt, and the largest debt, mortgages. In short, the United States has a debt issue, and part of this problem is that debt has gotten out of hand for so many people that the only way they can cope with this financial struggle is by ignoring it. In fact, the issue's gotten so bad that 10% of Americans say that they don't even think they will ever be free of credit card debt. So how has this issue propagated to this extreme? Debt has become an issue in Western culture for a few reasons. Firstly, most people are unaware of the almost infinite ways there are to make money, meaning that their income is limited to what their employer will pay them, which more often than not is not a lot. Second, people are in a constant struggle to compete with their peers in order to feel a sense of social validation, which they do through spending, which has been perpetuated by the rise in social media. Finally, debt operates in a vicious cycle. When debt isn't paid off, interest charges are added to the already insurmountable balance, meaning that the debt grows bigger and bigger over time. When this happens, people begin to ignore their debt completely, which has caused the United States to have more than $13 trillion worth of debt outstanding. So if you want to avoid this bad habit, then make paying your debt a top-of-the-list item on your agenda. Work out a plan for this and stick to it, no matter what. Habit number 7, constantly upgrading your electronic gadgets. It seems like every year, technology companies release new phones, computers, and tablets, making the ones we currently have even more obsolete than they already were. While the newest gadgets rarely have any significant differences in their functionalities, these companies know that on a psychological level, us humans are wired to want the latest electronics, but not because of their functions, but because of the social status that they can offer us. For instance, every year Apple comes out with at least one new version of the iPhone. And while some years the changes between models are significant, most years they aren't. But what does change is the fact that you no longer have the newest model iPhone, which leaves you as a social outcast if the rest of your social circle decides to upgrade their phones. And this phenomenon is pervasive amongst every material item in the world, like clothes and of course cars. Besides these upgrades being rather irrational, they erode our ability to save money. Upgrading your phone can easily cost a couple $100s, which could be put to much better use if it was saved, or better yet, invested. In short, it's okay to not have the newest gadgets, and if you aren't accepted by your peers because of it, then you're probably not hanging around with the right people anyway. So when you feel the urge to upgrade your electronics coming on, take a page out of William Shatner's playbook when he says, "If saving money is wrong, then I don't want to be right."